What's happening, guys? Keith here with another edition of the Impact Report. So this past week, we had a really good episode of Impact. I thought this was probably the best one since the new set of tapings started. You can check out my review by clicking the little icon above my head. I also want to just let you guys know that once we reach 200 subscribers, I'm going to be giving away an Impact Wrestling autographed. You guys can check out my unboxing video where I unboxed a few of these autographs that I now have up on the wall behind me, but I will be giving away the Suicide autograph that I received. So, let's get into things. Last night, we saw the premiere of the Impact Wrestling One Night Only Canadian Clash event on the Global Wrestling Network. I started watching it last night, unfortunately fell asleep during it, not because it was boring, just because I was exhausted. But from what I saw, it was a good show. I'm going to plan on watching the rest of it today. I'll give you guys a rundown of the card, so if you guys are interested in seeing it, you will know what to be expecting. So we have Moose versus EC3, Rosemary versus Casey Spinelli, LAX versus Trevor Lee and Caleb Conley, which that works perfect because that is the current feud. Desmond Xavier and Eddie Edwards versus OVE, the Crist Brothers. Bobby Lashley versus El Hijo de Fantasma, and Alberto El Patron versus James Storm. This is being advertised as James Storm's last match with Impact Wrestling. So this week on Conan's Keeping It 100 podcast, he brought up to Gail Kim that Impact should look into signing Io Shirai. Gail mentioned that she was on their radar. She was originally offered a WWE contract, I believe, last year before the Mae Young Classic, but WWE had rescinded this due to a neck injury, and apparently there was an issue with her heart that was later found out about, but basically this fell under WWE's general rule of not wanting to sign anybody with previous neck injuries or concussions. She was cleared by Japanese doctors to wrestle again, and she was awarded Women's Wrestler of the Year by Tokyo Sports for the past 3 years. Gail goes on to say that she would definitely be a great addition as they don't really have any high flyers in the knockouts division. So obviously this is just a rumor right now, and had she left Stardom to sign with WWE, that is all she would be doing. Right now, if she was to go work with Impact, she would probably still be able to work with Stardom. So this past week, we learned that Impact Wrestling will be broadcasting their April 7th WrestleCon event in New Orleans live on Twitch. I spoke about it briefly in my Impact review, but this is great for them. I think live shows, streaming anyway, would definitely bring in a good audience. I think they're talking about doing monthly Twitch shows. But advertised for the WrestleCon show is Austin Aries, Alberto El Patron, Eli Drake, the returning Teddy Hart, which we saw last week on the Brace for Impact show, Eddie Edwards, Moose, Matt Sydal, Trevor Lee, Caleb Conley, LAX, Taya, and Ali. Like I said, great that they're going to be streaming live. Hopefully we get more live shows in the future. As you know, it kind of brings a little more eyes to the product, besides having everything taped. Apparently, Matt Sydal suffered an injury recently as he missed yesterday's PWG show. I'm not sure what the injury is or the severity of it, but Sydal did take to Twitter and said that he was injured. Hopefully this is not a long-term injury and something that he makes a quick recovery on. I was wondering if maybe he wasn't injured previously, because last week on the Brace for Impact show, he had like one spot and that was it. Actually, 2 weeks ago it took place, and I think he wrestled the day before against Shane Strickland. So I'm wondering if something didn't happen then. Like I said, hopefully he makes a quick recovery and this doesn't screw up any plans in the future. So this past week on Impact, we also heard that the Redemption pay-per-view will take place on April 22nd. This is basically just confirmed by Impact. I had spoke about this a while ago. And it will take place in Orlando, Florida. I think a lot of the talent were relieved that it was going to take place in Florida, as I think most of them do live there. I mentioned that it was originally supposed to take place in Toronto, but that was never set in stone. So this will be the first time in years that Impact is running another live pay-per-view outside of Slammiversary and Bound for Glory. I'm glad they did add a pay-per-view in there, in between the two at least, because Bound for Glory took place back in November, and Slammiversary generally takes place around the summer. And that's like a nine-month gap between live pay-per-views. I know they do the monthly specials, like the Genesis one we saw recently, but I think the live shows will definitely bring more viewers and create buzz around the product. Hopefully they go with, you know, a four or five pay-per-views per year. I think that will definitely do well for them. This way they only have to tape, you know, a month or two worth of events. I'd rather they tape one at a time than have a live special tape another month and then have a pay-per-view or something like that. But again, it all comes down to money and logistics, so hopefully we get to that point sooner rather than later. So this past week's Impact drew 300,000 viewers, which was up from last week's 294,000 viewers, and ranked 130 on Cable's top 150. They're doing a good job staying around the 300 mark. Hopefully we can start moving that a little higher in the future. But like I said, this past week's episode was a really good episode. We saw the title match be the main event for the show. The crowd seemed more into it. I think this was night two of the taping, so I heard that it just gets better from here on out. We have a bunch of matches scheduled for next week, so that is good. And last but not least, this past week's Impact teleconference had Konnan, Josh Matthews, and Sami Callihan all on it. They spoke about the Rey Mysterio rumors, saying that both Impact and WWE has contacted Rey, and Konnan basically said that Rey will probably not work a full-time schedule, so who knows where he's going to go. Right now, he is wrestling for New Japan. I think he's slated to wrestle Justin Thunder Liger at the New Japan California show. Konnan also goes on to say that he is having hip surgery March 8th, and he will train for an in-ring return. He still has a score to settle with Sami Callihan, so I'm hoping that they kind of just push that storyline away for now, and then they'll eventually revisit it, which I think that's their plan. Callihan says that his only goal for 2018 is to be the Impact World Champion. I would be fine seeing that. Callihan apparently has brought a lot even behind the scenes to the promotion. He's just a guy that can show up anywhere, basically. Brian Pillman Jr. is brought up by Callihan, and he says he is hungry, has a great look, and is going to be a big star whether you like it or not. Konnan praised Brian Pillman Sr., as one of the realest guys in the business. Maybe there's a possibility we'll see Pillman Jr. in Impact Wrestling in the future. Sami also brought up Jessica Havoc, who is his real-life girlfriend, and he would like to see her back in Impact Wrestling, which I saw a bunch of fans took to Twitter and said they would like to see her back as well as a dominant force like she was. I would be all for this, as she has created a good following around her. Her work in the ring is pretty good, and yeah, the Knockouts division would only get better by adding her. He says that himself, OVE, and Brian Cage are all going to be cornerstones for the rebuilding Impact, which is good. And next week, Jimmy Jacobs will be on the conference call, and anything with him is fantastic. So I'm looking forward to that. That is all I have for you guys this week. I will see you next week for my Impact review. And as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.